Now, a Filipino drag queen drags the Catholic Church into a raging dispute. Philippine church leaders and lawmakers are incensed over his viral performance of one of Catholicism's holiest prayers. Willard Cheng reports.
A video has gone viral that shows a drag performance of artist Pura Luca Vega depicting Jesus Christ while a remix of the Lord's Prayer was being played and sang by the crowd. In a statement, Father Jerome Ceciliano of the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines, Episcopal Commission on Public Affairs said, "Dancing to the tune of a sacred and biblical prayer and wearing sacred costume is completely disrespectful of people and institutions practicing the faith and of God Himself." He adds, "Faith and sacred objects should not be used for entertainment purposes, but are useful for channeling the faithful's desire to the divine."
Disturbing yung nakita nating video, although sinasabi nila art daw ito, pero kapag binanood mo naman, malayo sa art eh. So ito talaga ay ginamit lang para makapag-entertain ng tao.
Bataan Representative Geraldine Roman expressed disappointment, saying she was offended and hurt by the action of a fellow member of the LGBTQIA community. On Teleradio Servicio, Roman said the performance cannot be covered by freedom of expression.
Their right to self-expression is not absolute. Siyempre, merong limitations yan. That right should be exercised with responsibility and of course with respect sa ibang tao.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri condemned the act, describing it as extremely blasphemous and offensive, a mockery of the Christian faith and disrespect of the Lord's Prayer. Zubiri considers it a misuse and abuse of freedom of expression that borders on criminal activity. He adds, a criminal charge under the revised penal code can be filed for offending religion and urge authorities to look into the matter. The person in the middle of the controversy, Pura Luca Vega, says the performance made during Pride Month was not intended to insult the Roman Catholic faith or Christ.
For the longest time, growing up as a queer person and then in a Catholic household or in the church, there are instances that you're made to feel that you don't belong. So this is my way of actually reconciling that with the queer crowd.
Luca found the song apt for the message that she wanted to convey.
Aking intention was really not to demean anyone or demean the image of Christ. I took advantage, I used it because I want people to feel that if Jesus were alive, He would love all people, including the LGBTQIA+ community.
Luca has no regrets but said sorry for those who were made uncomfortable for seeing the video.
I do apologize if I made people feel uncomfortable, but there's nothing much I can do about it. I don't intend to apologize for having done it. It was a controlled setting. It was a safe space for me to actually express that particular type of performance or that type of drag.
Senator Risa Hontivero says that while she found the incident regrettable, she hopes that it will not be used to deny rights and protections to a community that she said has long been marginalized and excluded. She called for compassion and healing for both the religious and the LGBTQIA+ community. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation denies plagiarism allegations involving its new logo. Bagcor's new emblem, which features a flame-like design in red and black, drew flak on social media after netizens noticed its resemblance with the logo of a website called Tripper. The gaming regulator says it is investigating the sources of what it called false and malicious claims. Progressive lawmakers, meanwhile, called for a probe into the controversial logo. The Makabayan Bloc says the project is a waste of funds, citing the over 3 million peso price tag for the logo design. The Philippine government testing a digital pass that will make it more convenient for Filipinos to travel to work abroad. Jeffrey Hernaez tells us more.
Ship Captain Arnel Sarabia is delighted that after many years of working abroad, he no longer needs to secure an Overseas Employment Certificate or OEC in the next few weeks. The government is scrapping the travel requirement for overseas Filipino workers and is replacing it with an OFW pass. It's pretty much the same with the OEC, but it can be secured easily through a mobile app.
Mas okay yon, mas pabor sa mga seafarers at saka sa lahat ng mga OFW. Makakatulong yan kasi medyo parang maluwag na siya kasi diretso na eh.
The Department of Migrant Workers says unlike the OEC that comes in hard copy, the digital OFW pass is a convenient and tamper-proof identification for OFWs. OFWs just need to download the DMW app, which will be available for both Android and Apple devices in the next few weeks. The DMW says it is still undergoing tests by the Department of Information and Communications Technology to further strengthen the security features. Once it is rolled out, OFWs can register using their mobile phones, take a photo of their passports, and lastly, pose for a selfie. If the passport and selfie matches, the OFW pass will then be issued. Instead of a 60-day validity, the OFW pass will have the same validity as the worker's employment contract. A transition period of 2 months will also be given where OFWs can still get OECs for free, as instructed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.
Sa OFW pass, basta na pasok na siya sa system namin, na-validate na siya, nakita namin na may work visa naman, And mamaya makikita nyo how it will work. Hindi na siya mag-worry every time na magbabakasyon siya. And kung kunyari man, alam namin kasi na may sitwasyon, may sakit yung tatay. So, uuwi yung anak para magbantay. Ngayon alam naman natin, minsan, na o-overextend yung ganon.
The DMW also gave its assurance that they are ready to assist overseas Filipino workers together with hundreds of volunteers who will serve as OFW Pass teachers. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.